Hello children, today we have come up with a new lesson, lesson number 3, A Greedy Heart, A Greedy Heart. Open page number 20 in your textbook, listen to the video and follow it. So what do you mean by greedy heart, children? So greedy heart means we should not be selfish. Okay, so we should be selfless or we should be generous. So what are you learning in this lesson in the sense? So a learning point is a greedy person looks only after his own welfare. So greedy person, what does he look? He looks only after his own welfare. So let us begin the lesson. Raman and Gopal were good friends. They were neighbors and went to the same school in their childhood. They played together, had their share of fights and fun too. They grew up and finished school. Raman's family did not have enough money to send him to college in the city. So he remained in the village and became a farmer. Gopal's parents sent him to college. He studied well and got a good job. He bought a big house and settled down with his family in the city. So there were two friends named Raman and Gopal, and they were very good friends. They were very good friends and they stayed next to their houses and they used to go to the same school since from childhood. They played together, they had fun, they had fights, they enjoyed each other together. They grew up and finished the school. So they grew up and they completed their school. And then Raman's family, they didn't have enough money to send him to city for the further studies, for college. So the Raman stayed back in the village and he became a farmer. But Gopal parents, they sent him to college. He studied very well and he got a nice job, good job. He purchased a big house and he settled in the city with his family. In the village, Raman too worked very hard and made good money. He bought a big orchard which gave the finest fruits. Raman and the fruits from his orchard became famous everywhere. Raman and Gopal are still friends. Raman sends his friend boxes of rare fruits from his orchard. They visit each other whenever they find some time. So in village, so Raman stayed back due to they did not have enough money. So he couldn't able to read and he became a good farmer and he stayed back in the village. So in village, Raman worked very hard and even he made a good money. And with that money, he purchased a land. He bought a big land and he planted fruit trees in his land, that is an orchard, which gave him a very good fruits to him, very fine fruits to him. And he and his fruit from his orchard, from his garden, became very famous everywhere. It became very famous for his very fine fruits. And still the Raman and Gopal, they were still a close friends. So Raman used to send his friends a boxes of these fruits from his garden, from his orchard. And they used to visit each other place whenever they find some time. One day, Gopal visited Raman's orchard. He was astonished at the fruits on the trees that stood neatly in rows. So one day what happened? Gopal went to Raman's place and he visited the orchard of Raman. And he was surprised by seeing the fruits on the trees which stood very neatly in rows. It was in a neat row and he was very surprised to see it. You are lucky to have such an orchard and enjoy fresh fruits all the time, he said. Look, my friend, replied Raman, I will give you an apple tree, the best one from my orchard. You and your children shall enjoy its fruit. So Gopal says that, so you are very lucky, Raman. You are very lucky. You have a beautiful fruits you have in your orchard, and you will be enjoying always the fresh fruits. Always you will be eating all the time. You will be eating, enjoying with the fresh fruits. So he said. So then the Raman replied, look, my friend, I'm going to give you an apple tree, the best one from my garden, the best one from my orchard. You and your children enjoy eating this fruits. Then Raman selected the apple tree. He called his workmen and ordered them to take it to his friend's house. They did so. The next morning, Gopal began to wonder where he should plant it. Then what happened? Raman selected an apple tree, the best tree, and he called his workmen. He called some people who is working in the garden, who is working in the orchard, and he asked them to take that apple tree to his friend's house, to his friend's Gopal's house. Then they took that to this Gopal's house. The workmen took the tree to his friend Gopal's house in the next morning, and then the Gopal started to think where to plant the tree now. If I plant it in front, he said to himself, the wind from the hillside might catch it and shake off its delicious fruits before they ripe. If I plant it close to the road, the passers-by may pluck them. If I plant it near the door of my house, my servants or children may pluck its fruits. After thinking for a long time, he decided to plant it behind his barn. Even thieves will not think of looking for it here, he said to himself. Now, once he get an apple tree from his friend Raman, so Gopal started to think, where should I plant this? If I plant in my front of the house, so will it be okay? He said to himself. Then he thought, like, if the wind from the hillside might catch it and shake off its delicious, if the wind blows, then what will happen? It will shake off all these fruits, and before they ripe, before they become fruit, everything will vanish. So the wind will take it off all the things. So then he thought, like, if I plant close to the road, if I plant outside the house near the road, then passerby, whoever will be walking on the road, they might pluck it. So let me not plant it near the road. Then he thinks, like, if I plant it near the door of my house, if he plants near the door of his house, then servants or the children will pluck the fruit. So he was thinking where to plant. Then after thinking a long time, he got an idea. So and he decided to plant it in his barn, in his outhouse. So he thought to plant in his outhouse. So then he said to himself that, yes, if I plant the plant in the outhouse, then even thieves, even the robber will not think to see there, look there. But the tree did not bear any flower or fruit in the first and the second years. Gopal then sent for his friend Raman. He said angrily, you have given me a barren tree instead of a fruitful one. You have deceived me. Then what happened? The tree didn't give any flower or fruit So he waited for first year, he waited for the second year. Now he sent back the treat to Raman and he was very angrily. The Gopal said, "No friend, you have not given me a good tree. So you have given me a barren tree. So you have given me infertile tree. So instead of the fruitful one, you have given me a barren tree. So now you have cheated me. So you have cheated me. You are not given a good tree to me." Then Raman wondered what could be wrong. Then Raman surprised and he thinks that what went wrong. He went and saw where the tree was planted. He laughed at Gopal. He said, "You have planted the tree in a place where it gets neither sun nor warmth. How then could you expect flowers and fruits? You planted the tree with a greedy heart. How then could you expect to reap a rich harvest?" Then Raman thought himself that what happened? What went wrong? So next day he went to Gopal's house and he saw where the tree was planted. And then he laughed at Gopal. He said, "Friend, you have planted the tree in a place where it gets neither sunshine, nor warmness, nor hotness at all. So then how can you expect the flower or a fruit? Plants require the basic needs, isn't it, children?" Yes. What is the plants required to grow? Plants require the sunlight, fertile soil, air and water, isn't it? So now there is no air, sunshine at all. So there is no warmth at all. Then how can the Gopal expect the plant to grow and give a fruits to him? So that is why the Raman says that you have planted the tree with a greedy heart. So you have not planted with a selfless heart. So you have planted the plant with a selfish heart. So how then you can expect to reap a rich harvest? Then how are you going to look for a rich crops? So if Gopal would have thought about the requirements of plants to grow, then the plant would have grown properly and it would have given a beautiful fruits to him. But he didn't think that. He became very selfish and he thought that neither servants or children or some thieves or somebody else, the passerby, might pluck. So he became very selfish. So then he doesn't have any plant with a good plant and now he cannot able to eat the fruits. So children, we should not be selfish. Children, a greedy person can never be satisfied. He is very selfish and always he asks for more and more and more. Okay, so let's read aloud. College, orchard, astonished, delicious, barn, deceived, barren, warm, expect, harvest. Isn't it a beautiful lesson, children? Yes. So hope you all enjoyed the lesson. Read the difficult words and also practice the difficult words in your notebook. So take care. Bye-bye.